Hi guys, so in today's video we're testing vegan makeup products, something that I have not done on this channel before, but I'm really looking to, you know, go into that vegan lifestyle. But as you guys know, this is a part of the vegan series. If you did miss Monday's video, it was trying home cooked vegan food. I'm not the best cook, so yeah, that was interesting. Obviously I'm being vegan for a week, so I am still cooking vegan food. I'm just not showing you guys on camera. Don't really see the point. But in today's video I'm just going to be testing and reviewing a product for every single step in your makeup routine, and the products are vegan. I have done some work into this, and I'm going to insert a clip of me reading all the ingredients and reading into all of the businesses and brands, just so you guys know that I have actually done the work to try and find out if these are vegan, because sadly there was a whole bunch of products that I got sent thinking they were vegan and sadly they're not. Obviously if you ever are curious about a product that you have and you just want to know if it's cruelty free or vegan, you can always search online. So what I actually did was I researched what ingredients were vegan and what ingredients aren't vegan, and then I looked at the products that apparently are vegan, kind of had to eliminate a few. Pass you over to Pastaz doing her thing, looking into the ingredients of stuff. Wow, this sounds so fun. I just started looking through some products and I've discovered that this one actually has glycerin in, so I can't use that sadly. And this one has carmine, or CI75470, for those of you that wanted to know. It's really good that I'm double checking these, because if not, I would have been promoting non-vegan products that I've been realizing. Obviously, this package has been put together for me claiming they're vegan, so I am just double checking. Okay, so I'm really confused. There is a brand that's called Evo, and at the bottom of every single bottle it says vegan, cruelty free, but in the ingredients it says glycerin, and that is something that isn't vegan. I'm gonna have like more of a look into it, because this product doesn't have it in, these two do have it in, so I don't really get it. So I've just done some reading on the internet, and there is three different types of glycerin. One's pronounced like glycerine, but you can get glycerin that is vegetable and plant-based, and I have a feeling it's the one that's in these, because it does claim to be vegan. I don't understand why they claim to be vegan if they were using animal-based fat product. I'm gonna assume that that is the one that they're using. If anyone is more knowledgeable on this, please let me know down below. A product, however, that I completely know is vegan is the new Urban Decay palette. And in the email, they specifically said that it was vegan and it was a cruelty-free palette, so of course I was gonna say yes. So after some further research, basically I wanted to look into Stila, because I actually do really want to try out these products. I haven't used them before. I did some digging, and apparently Stila a couple of years ago announced that they were cruelty free and that they stopped selling in China completely. They removed themselves off the trade, and they also do have some vegan products. Obviously again, took it upon myself to look at the ingredients, and these two products, after looking at the difference between glycerin and glycerine, I think they are vegan. But please, 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 if later on in this video, once I tell you the products, you know some backstory that they're not vegan, let me know, and I will try and put on a little thing in the description to let people know what is vegan and what isn't. That would really, really help me out. Obviously I'm just like a beginner. And now we can get straight into the makeup. Just trying to figure out if that's a parcel for me. Is it even a delivery guy? So as I said, after some research, I found out that Kiko was cruelty free and that they do actually do some vegan products. I just kind of had to check myself, and I actually discovered that their primer is vegan. Obviously again, this is one of the products I'm not too sure on, but I'm 99% sure it is vegan, so I am going to use it in today's video. Thank you so much for that. This primer feels like water. I really do apologize about my skin, by the way, guys. I literally don't know what the hell is happening to it. It's the worst it's ever been. I started to get all these spots over my cheek, all up here as well, and around my mouth as well. I thought it was my diet, so I tried cutting out fatty foods. I didn't really eat a lot of that anyway. So, not gonna lie, I do need to color correct under my eyes. They're looking a bit deader than me. This is the Color Correct Concealer Palette from Kiko. You guys can see it really does look like a powder, but it isn't. Oh, it literally is just like a concealer. It's definitely concealed my under eye circles very well. So if I remember correctly, purple is what covers spots. I'm gonna use the Cover FX contour brush. Is vegan, don't you worry guys. I'm definitely putting this on my cheeks as well, because have you seen these spots? We forgot her over here, didn't we? Of course we did. Oh, she's tender. I actually discovered that Beauty Blender is cruelty free and vegan, and I literally had no clue, otherwise I would have invested in these so much longer ago. Does that even make sense what I just said, so much longer ago? I don't think it does. I've got to answer the door with this on my face. Is DPD a parcel company? The foundation that I'm going to be using today is the Kiko Unlimited Foundation. After looking at the ingredients, from my knowledge, it is vegan. I mean, I look hella pasty right now. I don't think I have a bronzer.
I don't have a bronzer.
Instantly, whenever I think of cruelty-free makeup, I just think of Tarte. Just because of the whole thing recently that went about whether they are cruelty-free or whether they're not cruelty-free. And then on their website, they actually do have a vegan-friendly section, and Tarte Shape Tape was in there, which is amazing because I actually own two of these products. I've got the shades Fair and Light Neutral. Next up is actually powder, and we have a new brand. So this is PHB Beauty. They're all about being cruelty free and vegan friendly. Apparently the box is also eco-friendly, which is amazing. This is what the packaging looks like. So apparently it's a really light coverage. We love that for us. 6 months ago, a company got in contact with me that were called Kit Stars, and they were a brush company. They advertised themselves as vegan, having vegan brushes and everything. This is way before I even wanted to do this series. But to be fair, I never really thought about brushes being vegan and cruelty free. I got a PR package from them. They sent me so many brushes. They're literally incredible. And this one is the powder brush. Comes with a little thing as well to keep your brush safe. And when I tell you they are the softest brushes, that was not good. It just sticks to my face, and not in a good way. I didn't know if to try and put it under my eye, or just not even attempt that. Oh, would you look at that? Oh, yeah. This is bad. Here, this is bad. It's made me so white, guys. So Kiko recently released their Dark Treasures collection, and I've just read over the ingredients, and there isn't anything that I can see that means that it's not vegan. We're gonna roll with it. As I said before, if any of you guys know any inside deets, let me know, please. So this is the shaping veil. I'm gonna say that's it for bronzer. Not the best. I don't know whether that was the brush's fault or bronzer's fault. I'm gonna use the Pressed Mineral 6-piece palette from PHB. One of their eyeshadow shades are actually really reflective. We'll give it the benefit of the doubt. In its defense, it's a very, very pretty shade. So it's called the Frame of Mind Brow Sculpt in Pencil. And the ingredients are, oh, synthetic beeswax. So does that mean it doesn't? If it's synthetic. Oh, okay. Most of the time, synthetic beeswax is vegan. So I can use that then. I have a brow pencil. This is such a good day, guys. Wow. I'm only doing them lightly. I don't really fancy having, like, wild brows today. They don't look the same. Cool. Are we good? Are the brows all good? I think they are. Next, actually, is eyeshadow. So this is the Urban Decay Naked Cherry Palette. The packaging is to die for. I literally can't even deal. And I was so, so, so lucky enough to have this sent in the post to me. So thank you so, so much, Urban Decay, for this. Literally saved my ass. So this is the packaging again. I'm just gonna open it up. I think there's a brush in here. I don't want it to fall out. As I said before, this palette does claim to be vegan, so I'm gonna assume that they're brushes as well. So I'm just gonna take this shade that's called Hotspot, and I'm just gonna sweep that all over my lid. I'm definitely gonna use Privacy. That is definitely a shade I wanna use today. Devilish, defo fave. So I'm just gonna use a micro pencil from Kit Stars, and I'm gonna grab that Privacy shade. The formula of this is really reminding me of Jordan and Beauty Bay's recent palette. I feel like they have the exact same formulas. I've actually never had an Urban Decay palette, like I've never owned one. Next, I'm going to take the shade Bing just on the same brush because I can't be able to change it. I'm just basically putting that where I just put the other one as well, just so it blends out a bit more. I'm just bringing that right into my inner corner in the crease as well. Blend it out as well. I'm also just using the shade Juicy just because it's a nice peach tone. This is all vegan makeup.
Really?
Can you believe?
Well,
really? Crazy team. I think now I'm going to go in with the same shade that I used for my highlighter. I think this is Rose Quartz. No? Peach? No. I think this is Rose Quartz and that's peach. Oh my god, that is so nice. It really does work as a highlight. I'm also going to put that in my inner corner as well because I don't have any other highlight shades to use for my inner corner. And that works perfectly. What the hell? Eyeliner? Yeah, we're going to go eyeliner. The eyeliner that I'm using is from Kiko. Again, this is one of the products that I'm not too 100% sure on. So I'm just going to draw a wing like I normally would. Okay, so what is that then? I didn't even know you could get that from eyeliner.
Wow.
Okay, so it's just printed up onto my upper eyelid. Didn't know that was a thing with eyeliner. I'm now just going to curl my eyelashes and then we can go into mascara. Cool, so the mascara that I'm using is the All-in-One and Natural Mascara from PHB Beauty. Obviously, a lot of mascaras normally have beeswax in, that's why they're not vegan. However, this one doesn't. And I did try this out the other day. I didn't really think it gave my eyelashes anything more than what they naturally have. I mean, I really am trying to coat my lashes, but it's just not really working out. Again, two products that I'm not too certain on, but it's the matte lipstick from Kiko and the 3D Hydro Gloss from Kiko. I'm not really too sure if they even go together. I haven't even looked at the shade. Yeah, they definitely don't go very well together. I think I'm gonna put this one to the side. Okay, a nude. So far, so good. If I see 7.5, we're done for. We don't see 7.5. That is it. We're all good. We can use this lipstick. 316. It's called Velvet Passion. I am aware that I look so pale. I think that was the powder's fault. I'm gonna look for a darker shade and see if that's vegan as well. That's a dark gloss. Now let's look at the ingredients. No 7.5. So we're actually okay to use this, thank god. Yeah, that is the finished makeup look, I guess, using all vegan products. There's only really a few things that I'm not overly happy with. For example, the mascara. Okay, so I know I said in the video that I didn't have any lashes that were vegan. However, I got an email literally the day after I filmed my video for this brand called TGH Lashes. I've never heard of them before, but they are actually vegan. This is probably my favorite pair. Lipstick color, not really too keen on, but that's just personal preference. The actual lipstick is so good, and so is the lip gloss. Bronzer, I feel like, didn't really do me any justice. I still look pasty as hell. So I wouldn't really give the bronzer a big thumbs up. Maybe it wasn't my shade. Maybe I needed darker. I don't know. I just didn't really like the formula. I didn't really think it spread across my face very nicely. One product that I absolutely loved, though, was the Color Correction Palette from Kiko. Wow. Like, that probably was my favorite thing. I didn't even know it was a thing until I got gifted it. I will leave the names to all the products in the description just in case you're looking to, you know, branch out to more of a vegan lifestyle and you just kind of wanted to know where to get the products from. I will definitely leave links down below. Lovely. I really hope you did enjoy me trying out some vegan makeup. I hope it helped you guys a little bit. Next time you run out of a mascara or next time you run out of foundation, please try and go for vegan alternatives. Even if it's a cruelty-free alternative, like, you're still contributing to that change that we desperately need. I don't understand why people test animals. It does not need to be a thing. This is one of the main reasons why I even wanted to do this series, because I just don't agree with half the stuff that us humans do to poor animals. From now on, I'm going to try as much as I can to eliminate products that do test on animals from a makeup routine. This is not going to be me throwing them out, obviously, because there are products that I've recently bought that I've found out, sadly, that they are tested on animals. I'm basically just going to use these products until they run out, and then the next time I need to buy new products, I'll try and go for a more cruelty-free or vegan option. I mean, there's so many more products. There's so many more brands that are vegan and are cruelty-free that I haven't even included or mentioned in this video. Do a little bit of extra research, and you can definitely find out for yourself. Thank you so much for watching my video, guys. I really hope you did enjoy. If you did, hit the like button down below, hit subscribe, comment, do all that jazz that you normally do. All of my social media links will be in the description. My Instagram will be on the screen. That's where I'm most active. And I will see you guys on Friday for testing vegan restaurant foods, I guess you can call it. Not really too sure on the title yet, but it's along those lines.